Tricks are for kids, I'm loving it, taste the rainbow. I'm sure all of these slogans sound very familiar to you. And that's because as kids, we were all bombarded with these junk food advertisements that we absolutely shouldn't have been exposed to. Today in America, childhood obesity is an absolute epidemic. Over 33% of children are affected by childhood obesity. Why does this affect you guys? Well, I'm sure a lot of us are going to have our own children. And as parents, we're going to want our kids to lead very healthy, happy lives. And we cannot do this if we are burdened with obesity-related diseases such as diabetes, metabolic syndrome, and other inflammatory diseases, and even premature death. I think I am credible to talk about this topic because I am a nutritional sciences major, so I know a lot about how nutrition affects the body and other nutrition-related diseases. The main points that I will be discussing are about childhood obesity and the issue that it is in America today, the ban on junk food advertisements that I propose we implant in the United States, and the future that we might have as a country if we do place this ban. So to begin, childhood obesity is a national epidemic. The American Journal of Public Health states that over the past 20 years, obesity has been increasing steadily among Americans. Every one-third adult and one in six children are affected by obesity today. This chart shows the increasing rates of obesity from children ages 2 to 19. This is from 2011 to 2014, so this is very recent. The World Health Organization states that less than 10% of free sugars, preferably less than 5% of free sugars, are recommended to be part of our diet. This means that a free sugar is an added refined sugar into a food that does not need that sugar. For example, fructose in strawberry is not a free sugar. That is a component of the strawberry. But when we add refined cane sugar to like cookies or any other types of sweets, those are free sugars. The World Health Organization also states that a substantial fall in sugar intake is absolutely necessary to halt the rise of diabetes and obesity to reduce premature deaths by 25% by 2025. That is only 7 years away, and that is a huge drop in premature deaths. Yes, deaths. That is a big statement. The Frontiers of Bioscience says that intake of sugar is associated with diabetes, metabolic syndrome, and other inflammatory diseases. So why do we care about this? Well, why are kids not being, fed properly? Well, the media does not give them a chance to be fed properly. The media only shows us junk food, junk food, junk food. So how can kids possibly know in their young, impressionable, uneducated minds to avoid these foods if that's all we're exposed to? Especially in today's day and age, kids are overcome by the media. The media has been so prevalent in many kids' lives, as I'm sure many of you have seen. The Parliament of Australia found that 99% of all youth-targeted food advertisements were junk food advertisements. 99% is basically all food advertisements. That means only 1% of food advertisements were for healthy foods. And that is worldwide. That is a huge number. That is not okay. The Parliament of Australia also found that the ban that Norway placed on junk food advertisements actually resulted in a decrease of 18% consumption of saturated fat and a decrease of 10% consumption of cholesterol. While those bans were not sugar specified, they are still nutrition related, and it is absolutely a generalizable topic. The United Kingdom placed a similar ban, and the Parliament of Australia found that in that case, children saw 34% fewer junk food advertisements when that ban was placed. That is 34% less exposure to junk food advertisements. That's a huge number, and then a lot healthier population. To continue, what would our future look like with this ban? Well, the National Institute of Health, which I'm sure many of you have heard of, conducted a study where 13,000 children's viewing patterns were studied after a fast food advertisement ban that was proposed to decrease childhood obesity rates by 18%. Childhood obesity rates are currently 33%, and 18% decrease is a huge decrease, and that is a much healthier population and a much happier population. I propose that a future on this ban would look more like this. In the first slide that I showed you, obesity was increasing at a positive slope. In this bar graph, we have a negative slope, and that's what I hope to see in the near future. So in summary, I talked to you about childhood obesity and the issue that is in America and its causes. The ban that I propose, that we ban all junk food advertisements in the media, and the future that our society could look like if we do place this ban. Children are our future. If we do not have a healthy, productive population of children in our future, what is America going to become? Nothing. If our kids are not healthy enough to produce and be good leaders, do well in school, and do something good for our country is not going to be a country anymore. That is why this is so important. I invite all of you today to take a stand against the malicious effects that junk food advertisers have on society. I think that junk food advertisers immorally take advantage of children in order to produce a profit for themselves. This is not okay. I hope that all of you after today call your legislators, write to your legislators, your state representatives, influence the children of our population to lead healthy lifestyles so that the junk food advertisers do not get the best of our children. The kids are our future, and we must act now. Do I have any questions? Yes.
What like age range will be affected by the ban?
So generally, when I say children, I mean 0 to 16. The study done in Norway was 0 to 12, and that showed to be very effective. So I think even if we could just target children ages 0 to 12, that could really have a profound impact. So I would say 0 to 12.
Has a ban in America been placed like this before?
So there was a proposal that junk food advertisers would receive fewer subsidies, but that was not passed. But that was just a proposal that I think could have worked, because if junk food advertisers are not, you know, if they have to pay more to advertise, you know, they're less inclined to advertise as often as they are. But that did not pass. So no, there has been no ban. Any other questions? Yeah.
What kind of platforms would this ban take place across?
So definitely all of television, especially like Disney Channel, Nickelodeon, Cartoon Network, all of those, you know, child channels. And I hope also, you know, in video games, magazines, any platform that children have access to, iPads, apps, I mean, everything has advertisements now, Facebook, so all of those platforms. Anything else? Thank you for listening.